you have any question, please ask me. Because in Hong Kong, no, first of all, it's a bit strange in this sense, because I always want to use that name as a movie title, okay? Because my husband has that sort of a sickness, because like for instance, he can't sit in the inner seat of in a booth, and he can't be seated next to the window on a plane. And I think in Hong Kong, well, we happen to have we are very small, and then we have 7 million people, which is twice the number of people you have here. And we are so used to living and working and moving around in very crowded spaces. So I think if you think of it that way, then Hong Kong has the least outbreak of claustrophobia. But sometimes I remember when I was pregnant, I was caught in a very crowded commuter train, and I feel like, you know, running out of the door, I mean, even though the train is moving. So I think people in Hong Kong have been so used to be in a crowded space that, you know, you don't realize you have that, you have a problem at all. So it's a very typical situation in Hong Kong, as well as in all the major cities in China, and in all the major cities in Asia. If you go to Seoul and Japan and Tokyo, you will find the same situation. So people keep asking me this, why? Because the Chinese title is quite different from the English one. The Chinese title says intimacy. So there's only a thin line between intimacy and claustrophobia. You never know when you are going to cross that line. I'll certainly do better work next time. You know, this is a very this is a divine providence, because I never, this picture was never intended to be directed by me. I wrote a script 3 years ago. It was actually meant for another director, but then, you know, he shelved it, and there's no sign of his going to make it at all. So, and because I spent, this also happens to be a script that I spent a long time on, because originally, the first draft is not working, and but by the time I get to the second draft, I feel so attached to it. I suddenly think, you know, this is not going to be a healthy baby, but somehow I want to make sure it will be born one day. And I know that this, you know, I am also skeptic about whether or not it will be seen as a commercial film. Because in Hong Kong, only films with commercial value can survive. That's why we work with a very, small budget. And but then, you know, it's all these that make me determined to turn my words into celluloid. And I think if I can do it again, it might be a little better. But in terms of the tight schedule. All this was shot in 16 days. Yes, 16 days. So it's a very hectic schedule. We managed to pull through. So thank God. Well, I would say some people might think Jewel, the other girl, is quite typical of a Hong Kong, average Hong Kong girl. She's more typical. Karena is not, but Karena is epitomizes the kind of Asian girls. She is more shy, more conventional, more reserved. So on the surface, those outspoken characters, you know, are more like Jewel's character. Whereas I believe there are plenty of Pearl in Hong Kong and in China. But you don't usually hear them or see them, because they are not talking. Oh, the fish is claustrophobia. I mean, you see so many fish. You know, this is a favorite kind of fish. They are big, but sometimes they are. That actually is a real life experience. It's my doctor. Oh well, that doctor has nothing to do with the doctor you just seen. But It happened to be what I'm looking at whenever I went to see that doctor. That's what's my comment too once. You know, how can you keep so many big fish in such a small tank? Well, he said, sometimes I rotate them between home and the office. Oh, I feel so sorry for those fish. Well, first of all, I would like to say a thank you to Harold Pinter, because he's the one who inspired me some 23 years ago when I saw his betrayal at the movie adaptation of his play. And it consists of three scenes, and all going backward like that. And I would say, wow, because I never realized, you know, you can tell a story that way. And this is a very good, I was stunned. And I feel it works so much like our mind, because when you try to retrieve a memory, you go like that. Something sparks your memory, and then why do I suddenly remember this? And then you go back all the way. So it works just like memory. And I that film stayed in my mind for a really long time. And I think this is a commonplace love story. It's not a love story at all, as you may realize. And so it's a petty little thing that, you know, the origin is petty as well. But I want, if I turn it backward and turn it into a mystery, without saying too much about what's going on, maybe people might want to find out exactly what started in the beginning. That's just my, well, some people did question why I have to use that, because they feel it's still okay if you tell the story forward, if you tell the story in the usual chronological order. I don't know, I still have no answer. Maybe I don't need to, I don't know. But I think I like the way it is now.
Okay, thank you very much for coming and for